Or subscribe and welcome back to the YouTube video. So in this video, we are going to create a ransomware in Python.
So that's just a mask that I just bought recently, so I just thought of showing in front of the camera. You know what I mean. So as the title says, today we are going to create a ransomware malware. Of course not, we are not going to create any malware in this video. In today's video, we are going to learn how to encrypt and decrypt videos or different files using Python. So today we are going to learn how to use AES encryption. So AES encryption is generally the encryption in which we need a key. First of all, you have to create a key and use that key to encrypt a file and save that file. So in order for the decryption of that file, you need that key, otherwise that file will be lost. So you need the key, and the key will be only used to decrypt the file. So otherwise it will show like invalid key error, something like that. So it will be like ransomware, but not ransomware. You know what I mean. So as you know about ransomware, ransomware is a malware which will actually generally encrypt all the files and images and everything inside a person's computer and actually show a screen something like this. So it will be actually asking the person Bitcoin as payment, and after the payment, hopefully the computer will be decrypted using the key, and of course sometimes not. So we are going to learn how to encrypt and decrypt files in Python. So with that being said, let's get started. So guys, the first step is to install cryptography module into your device. So just open up the terminal and type in pip install cryptography. So it is a module that we are going to use today for encrypting and decrypting files. So I have already done that, so I'm not going to do that. You have to only install this module, get pip install cryptography. So after that, we are going to open up VS Code. You can use whichever text editors that you prefer, so I'm going with VS Code. And opening up that. So as you can see, I already created a folder named safe right over there, so I'll just minimize this. So as you can see, if I open the safe folder, so this is the files that I'm going to protect using encryption. So this is the two files. This is an image file of Python logo. So if you can open that. So as you can see, this is a image of Python logo, and if I go back and come down inside in here, this is a file named S with some code. Let me just go ahead and change this to "this is a secret file." Okay, secret file. Save that and close this. So today we're gonna learn how to save this file from others and encrypt and store this file using the cryptography module. So this is what we are actually trying to do. So let me just go and open this folder into our VS Code. So see if I can open up VS Code. Okay, here we are. So open folder and open that safe folder right over here. So inside desktop safe. All right, now here we are inside the working folder. So now let us get started by creating a new file. So it will be encryptor.py. So first file will be encryptor.py. We have to save that encryptor.py. And the second file will be decryptor.py. So I'm going to create new file decryptor.py. So we decryptor.py. Decryptor.py and save that to decryptor.py. Okay, here we are. We have opened encryptor as well as decryptor.py. So what I am going to try to do is here is that we are going to use encryptor.py to encrypt the files inside this folder, and the decryptor.py to decrypt the files inside this folder. So first of all, let's get started by encryptor.py. So inside in here, I'm going to import from cryptography dot furnish, furnish import furnit. So we are going to first of all create keys using the furnit cryptography module. So so first of all, let me say key is equal to furnit dot generate key. Yeah, that's right. Generate key, and just print out the key to screen just for sake to showing that. So generally this will actually create a key. It will be changing from time to time as you run. So if we can run this one. So as you can see, it generated a key right over here. So if I run that again, it will actually generate a new key. So as you can see, it's completely different. It is generating new keys as you run again, 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 and again. So now we have to actually, change the working directory of the Python. Change the working directory to this directory, and then encrypt all the files inside this directory. For that, we need OS module too. So we can import OS module, and also we are going to actually create change the working directory. So if I can print the current working directory of the program, so if we can use os.getcwd, so you could actually print the current working directory using the OS module. So if I run this, so as you can see, it is currently working on the same directory as expected. We don't need to change because the Python file is in the same folder. Am I stupid? No, I'm not. So now, let's get started by for I in os.work, and it will generally take the current working directory as the parameter, get cwd. So what it will actually do is that it will actually, you know, traverse through this directory. Os.work will traverse, it will actually return a tuple, which stands for, we're just going to print and see what we have, right? So if I can print I, and let's see what it will print. So as you can see, it actually printed out a tuple, which stands first one is the path to which the folder is, and the second one will be the subfolders, I guess, and the third one is the file inside the folder. So we are going to target a PNG file as well as text file. So if you encrypt every file in this directory, it will actually make the .py files also encrypted. So it is a bad feature, right? So for j in I, so the I is getting looped again, and it will say if I of third one, so it will actually get this list over here. So I'm going to use for I in, so it will be I of 3. We can do it from here itself. For I in I of 3, and if I can print j, so let me just come print and see how it goes. So if I can print, oops, it was not 3, it was actually 2. Run again. Oh shit, for j, right. It'll probably work. Yes, there we are. So here we are, we have successfully printed out every file in this folder. So now you have to check if the file ends with png or text file, which is our target files. So I'm going to say str of j dot ends with, first of all, let's target the txt file. So ends with txt, then we can do something. So now if it ends with txt, we are going to open that file. So open S dot, I mean, not S dot DXT, it will be J. So it will be str of J, and for opening as opening for read. So we have to first of all read and encrypt and save that file. So it'll be as f and say data is equal to f dot read. So that is what it is. Now we have to create an encrypted object. So encrypted is equal to, we'll say, so this is the key that we have generated, right? So we have to actually save this key for future, I mean, decryption, right? So we are going to create a new file named key file. So it's open key dot key for writing binary as f dot write the key to the file. So that's it. And now coming down in here, we say encrypted is equal to, before that we have to also create another object for encryption. So we'll say fernet is equal to fernet of key. So we are going to pass this key inside in here, which can be used for encryption and decryption of the file. So say it will say fernet dot encrypt and let's pass the data to be encrypted. So let me just print out the data for now and see if everything is working properly as expected. So we can print out and run this one. Data must be byte. Yeah, data is currently as is an str, is in string, so you have to encode that to bytes. So if I run that again, and here we are, you can see this is the encrypted data inside this s.txt. This is a secret message, and this is the data, I mean this is a string which is in encrypted form. So now you have to write the string back to the file. So if I can open that with open str of j for write in binary and say as f and say f dot write the data. So now if I run this program, it will actually overwrite the s.txt file with the new encrypted data, and we'll get also get the key.key file right over here. As you can see, key.key file is over here, and this is the secret key of the encryption that I have created right now. So if you can run again, and here we are. We had to write encrypted data into this file, not data. So if you can run again, and hopefully it will work. So if I come back inside in here, you can see key has been changed, and go to s.txt, and you can see a big encrypted data is right over there. No one will understand what message is, and no one can decrypt without using or having this key. So now we have to use the decryptor to decrypt the data. So for that, I'm going to say from cryptography dot fernet import fernet, and we are going to open that file and get the key for decryption process. So we'll open up key dot key and use the key for reading as reading in binary and as f and you say, I mean not data, it's key, right? Key is equal to f dot read. So it will actually get the key from the key.key file. So now we have to pass the key to the fernet class. So we have to create the fernet class first of all. Fernet is equal to fernet, and we will pass on the key, and we are going to actually, you know, decrypt the data from the file. So we know that we have actually encrypted this TXT file. So I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste this from here over here. So instead of encrypting, we have to decrypt the data. So we are going to read that in binary. So read in binary, and it will be the data. So I'll say rename this as decrypted right over there, and we, instead of encrypting, we'll decrypt that data. Decrypt, and we don't have to encode that again because it's already in binary format. So after that, we have to write. Okay, we can write in binary, not problem. So hopefully this will work. Otherwise, the file will be lost, right? So guys, let me just go and correct the spelling of this decrypted right over there, and over here too, decrypted, and there we are. So let me just go and run. First of all, the encrypted. First of all, let me just change this to, this is a secret file, and this is the data inside the TXT file. So let me just go and run the encrypted.py. And here we have successfully encrypted the file. So now if I can run decrypted.py, and come back to the s.txt, and you can see, voila, we have got the secret message back. So see if we can do the same thing to this python.png file. So if I can open that, yeah, as you can see, the python logo is right over there, and we are going to encrypt this python logo. So we have to, instead of doing for txt, we are going to use png now, png, and read it in binary, and delete the encode class. And you can see now we have got successfully changed the code to png. So generally it will actually use, see if the file ends with png format, and read the file and encrypt the file, and overwrite the same file with the encrypted data. So coming back to decryptor, for the decryption of png file, we have to change the txt to png, and read it in binary, and write it in binary. So hopefully it will work. Let's see if it can work. So if I can write this one, there we are. So if I can come back to python.png, an error occurred while loading the image, so no one can read this image except you. So as you can see, key.key, this is key to the file, opening of the file. So running the decryptor.py, but hopefully without an error. Yeah, there we are. So coming back to p.python.png file, and here we are, we got the image back. So now for the fun part, let us go ahead and encrypt all the files inside my desktop like a ransomware attack. So if I can run this encryptor.py, run that, and we go back to here. Okay, so if we can minimize this, you can see it is getting encrypted, and the image is currently starting to get disappear. See if I can open one. So if I can open this Python logo file, so it's coming loading up, and Python, it looks like we don't support this format. So it is actually encrypted and stored. We cannot actually retrieve this file without using this key. If this key is lost, everything is lost, the file will be gone. So we are not going to do that. So we are going to decrypt that back. We can run this program, come back in here, and let's see the magic of decryption. As you can see, we got every file back. So that's what it is. So today we have learned how to encrypt and decrypt files on Python. Hopefully I have made a lot of errors. I was not really prepared for this tutorial. So thank you guys for watching this video. So if you have any questions or comments regarding this topic, just put it in the comments below. I'll definitely be checking that. So please subscribe, support us. Thank you for watching, and have a nice day.